L'eau qui est à la base de toute vie sur Terre est aussi
au essential for life on Earth, but it is also at the core of the strategy for sustainable development, trying to meet the needs of human beings, health, safety, comfort, while preserving natural balances such as that of water, threatened by our polluting and aggressive activities. Growing needs in urban areas, industrial and agricultural areas, have resulted in the overexploitation and contamination of water, water which is a fragile but precious natural resource. Water renews itself with a cycle in three phases, the marine phase, oceans and seas. Water evaporates under the energy delivered by the sun, becomes vapor and forms clouds. Then clouds, when there is bad weather, will release their content in the form of rain or snow, part of which will go through the soil to fill the aquifers, and the other part will run off down the slopes into rivers and lakes and back into the sea. And the cycle starts again. During the continental phase, water geography results in landscapes with plains, lakes, rivers, and this is where the history of water starts, with human societies and sedentary societies which have always tried to settle down close to rivers and lakes, and in hot climates, underground water is being drawn and used, sometimes carried through underground galleries towards the storage reservoirs, and then palm fields and oases. For instance, in southern Iran, there is Yazd, an oasis with a beautiful heritage of underground galleries. Some towns also developed along rivers, such as Seville, where the Guadalquivir, which means a great river in Arabic, runs through the town. During the continental phase, water resources are used, distributed, shared, they are used for drinking water, and then they are evacuated and sanitated again before being released in the natural environment. This is the urban cycle of water. In some countries, depending on the development level and the local availability, underground water resources are used, and sometimes above ground resources are used more. Water resources are therefore conventional in those cases. Sometimes non-conventional water resources are being used, for instance, desalination of seawater or recycling wastewater to make it into drinking water again. But in some countries, stringent rules prevent the population from recycling wastewater and using it again as drinking water. When the wastewater is not sufficiently processed, there is a danger for human health and the environment as well. This, unfortunately, worsens the susceptibility of local populations and may lead to damage on the environment and the goods. Therefore, the Sustainable Development Strategy recommends an integrated resource in water, an integrated management of water resources, saving water, preserving the quality of water, and reducing the risks such as pollution, shortage, landslide, floods, etc. In that case, territorial administrations are no longer the management body, and rather the catchment area manages the water from the upstream part of the river to the downstream, whether we're talking about above ground water or underground water, and valleys also become the ideal area for land planning. The town, with its urban planning, will take care of its own use of resources by recovering rainwater and processing wastewater. There are water-sensitive urban designs associating landscape planning with modern sanitation techniques, facilitating infiltration of rainwater in the soil or storage of rainwater in reservoirs, and the use of recycled wastewater. In urban areas, there are green or mineral devices to help infiltrate aquifers or gather water in very specific reservoirs. And embankments are also structured in such a way that the risk of pollution and floods is reduced. Agriculture is the greatest consumer of water. 70% to 90% of the water is used by agriculture. Human needs, however, will be increasingly difficult to meet in the future because of demography and the increase of urban areas. Therefore, it's absolutely essential to multiply the number of interventions so that we can facilitate the urban water cycle, preserving both the quality and the quantity of water available for land dwellers while preventing the associated risks, and harmonizing the urban water cycle and global water cycle.
Right.